The story begins with two boys named Alfred, growing up in Switzerland in the early years of the 20th century. Alfred Neff in Ernesch, Alfred Gonsenbach in Roggwil.
Yeah, my father was born in 1902. Interesting, he was born in a castle that had been in the Gonsenbach family from about 1850 till about 1950. A castle sounds pretty intriguing, and it was that, so to speak, but by that time it was strictly an apartment house, full of apartments, but they dwelled in one of the apartments in the house. In the very lower level of the castle, there was a cheese factory.
The Gonsenbachs owned some land, milked cows, raised hogs, and cultivated fruit. They never made cheese, but that's what young Alfred wanted to do. He got started as soon as he finished his primary education.
At age 17, then, he basically went off to pursue cheese making. He went to an operation not too far from where his home and lived there, and that's where he started and went through basically the apprenticeship journeyman and on through that the progress of the vocational experience of that time, and essentially became a master cheesemaker.
His employer had connections in the U.S. in Monroe, Wisconsin, a town in a county with a large Swiss immigrant population. Alfred Gonsenbach saw an opportunity and came to America. Although he came from a farm family, Alfred Neff never made cheese in Switzerland. After completing his primary education, he earned a degree from an agricultural school. He spoke German, French, and Italian, and had a reputation as a smart and exceptionally energetic young man who lacked opportunity in Europe.
My father grew up in not a really poor family in Switzerland, but they didn't have much on the table. And he grew up during the World War I era, and then just after that, Western Europe wasn't very prosperous. And he ran into some Swiss American who said, "You better go to the land, go to the United States. That's the land of milk and honey." So at age 19, he made that basic decision.
Alfred Neff came to Chicago and found farm work in the area. The story goes that he got into cheesemaking only because he had to fill in for a coworker who missed work for a few days. The two Alfreds traveled separate paths when they first got to the U.S. They finally met at a craft company cheese factory in Antigo, Wisconsin. They were two of several Swiss immigrant cheesemakers on the craft payroll in Antigo.
They decided, let's see if we could. They apparently had a good relationship, and not known each other in Switzerland, but nonetheless, the chemistry was right, and they decided to strike out for themselves.
The next thing you know, they're in business running a little cheese factory in Wisconsin, and they had some issues, and things weren't perfect.
There were issues with the owner of the building they were renting, a few issues with local milk supply, and a few issues with trying to run a tiny cheese factory in Wisconsin, which already had plenty of large cheese plants.
Mr. Gonsenbach went on a mission to go to Montana to look for a place for a cheese factory and have to stop here to overnight and got talking to people. Next thing you knew, he never got any further.
He stopped here in Milbank late afternoon for some gas. His plan was to go on to Aberdeen and spend the night and then continue on from there.
Some of the locals at the filling station noticed the Wisconsin license plate and struck up a conversation. When they found out he was heading to Montana to look for a site for a cheese factory, they said, "Hold on."
One very industrial-minded chap said, "Oh gosh," he said, "we've got a good farming community here. We got a lot of farmers, a lot of cows in this area. Boy, a cheese factory would be a good fit for our town here." He said, "Why don't you consider it?" Well, Dad said, "It's late in the afternoon. I guess I can stay overnight and look around."
Alfred Gonsenbach went out into the country the next day. He talked with local dairy farmers about whether they'd be willing to sell their milk. The farmers didn't seem too excited by the idea.
In fact, that evening, he said, he went to see George Juergens, the implement dealer, to find out where he lived, because he was the one that really encouraged him, and went to see him and said, "George, I think I'm going to go on. I appreciate the time, but I couldn't find much interest here for us to stay."
Juergens couldn't believe it. He convinced Alfred Gonsenbach to stay a little longer and do another round of farm visits. This time, Juergens came along.
Dad said the reception was entirely different. He had credibility, and that made all the difference. And after he came back, Dad said, "You know, I think we're going to go back to Wisconsin with my partner, and bring or come back with my partner, and then they came back then on Armistice Day 1928.
After making an orderly exit from the Wisconsin business, they came to Milbank. It took them about 3 months to set up their operation in an unused city-owned water filtration plant. They opened on March 1, 1929, and took in one 10-gallon can of milk. But things improved quickly. Having two Alfreds in the same shop was confusing, though, so their American nicknames soon found them. Alfred Gonzenbach became known as Gonzi. Alfred Neff was known as Shorty. He wasn't short, but he seemed to be when he stood next to Gonzi.